Sir, in today's class, we discuss about electrochemical cell and Gibbs free energy of the reaction. Okay? Now, we have already discussed what you mean by electrochemical cell. An electrochemical cell is a cell in which chemical energy of the reaction is converted into electrical energy. So, let's see how this change of chemical reaction into electrical energy, due to which there is decrease in the free energy. Due to which there is decrease in the free energy of the reaction. Okay, that is Gibbs free energy of the reaction. It decreases when this chemical reaction or chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Okay, now we know that work is done in moving the charges across a potential difference. Okay, now here between two electrodes. So here I told you there is relation between the conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy and decrease in the free energy of the reaction. Okay. So here let's see how the free energy of the reaction decreases when electrical work is done. Okay. So what is electrical work done here? We have to move the charges. We have to move the charges from one electrode to the other electrode. There is some potential difference between the electrodes. Between the two electrodes there is a potential difference. So, you have to move the charges from the anode to cathode, right? So, these electrons, they have to move from anode to cathode through some potential difference. So, there will be some work done when these charges are moved through a potential difference. Okay, so that is the electrical work done in case of electrochemical cell. Not really, eh? One cell like this. Cell like an electrode, sadawa. How that? Now one electrode in the bare electrode the electrons transfer maadbeku. How that? Then electrode no potential difference. A potential difference through now en maadbeku? Electrons transfer maadbeku. One electrode in the bare electrode the. So ili electrical work done andre en aagtiti? Aa charges move maadakka now en work maadtivalla. Adakke now en antivi? Electrical work done. So the electrical work is done when the charges are moved from one electrode to the other electrode through some potential difference. Okay, so here there is a relation between the Gibbs free energy of the reaction and the EMF of the cell, which is given by delta GR is equal to minus NF into E cell. Delta G R. Delta G means what? Gibbs free energy. R means Gibbs free energy of the reaction. N is what? Number of electrons involved in the reaction. F is what? Faraday's constant, 96,500 coulombs. E cell is what? It is the EMF of the cell. Right. So here, now in case of Daniell cell. Now Daniell cell is made up of two half cells. Which are the two half cells in Daniell cell? One is the zinc half cell. Other is the copper half cell. How many electrons are involved in the reaction? Two electrons are involved. So, instead of 2, what should I write? It will be 2. F into E cell. Okay. Now here, this is at any condition when the concentration is not unity. Okay. Suppose the concentration is at unity. When the concentration is unity, this is modified as delta G naught R. Not symbol A indicate, but with the standard conditions of temperature and concentration. Standard temperature is what? 298 Kelvin. Concentration should be what? 1 molar. So, minus NF into. Since the concentration is 1 molar or unity, it will become E naught cell. It will become E naught cell. Right. So, this is the relation between standard Gibbs free energy and the EMF of the cell. Delta G naught R is equal to minus NF E naught cell. Now, why this is minus? We have already discussed in the first year. That is, a reaction is spontaneous only when there is decrease in its Gibbs free energy. Only when there is decrease in the Gibbs free energy, the reaction will take place spontaneously. Means for a spontaneous process, delta G should be less than 0. Delta G should be less than 0. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Okay, once again I will repeat. When we are moving the charges from one electrode to the other electrode through some potential difference, there will be potential difference between the two electrodes. So electrical work is done in moving the charges from one electrode to the other electrode. This electrical work done will cause decrease in the free energy of the system or the reaction, which is given by delta Gr is equal to minus Nf into E cell, where delta Gr is what? Gibbs free energy of the reaction. Gibbs free energy, how do we define? It is the energy of the system which can be converted into useful work. That is known as Gibbs free energy. Right? So here, N is number of electrons involved in the reaction. F is what? Faraday's constant. E cell is what? EMF of the cell. Okay? Potential difference between the two electrodes, that is the EMF of the cell. Okay, so here, now under standard conditions, what happens? Delta Gr becomes delta G naught R. Naught means what? Standard conditions of temperature and concentration. Okay, E cell will become what? E naught cell. Okay, so that is the relation between Gibbs free energy of the reaction and the EMF of the cell. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Now, one more thing. Gibbs free energy of the reaction is an extensive property. Extensive property means what? Property which depends upon the quantity present in the system. Okay, like for example, what is the overall reaction? We write for a Daniell cell. This is the reaction we write for Daniell cell. Okay, when we double the concentration, when we double the number of moles of copper and zinc, what it will happen? 2Zn plus 2Cu2 plus, giving you what? 2Zn2 plus plus 2Cu. Concentration is double, right? So here, what will happen? Number of moles of electrons is double, right? So delta Gr becomes what? Minus, instead of N, it will be 4, 2 into 2. 4 moles of electrons are involved. So 4F into E cell. So we say that Gibbs free energy is an extensive property. Property which depends upon the quantity present in the system. But E cell, EMF of the cell, is an intensive property. The property which does not depend upon the quantity present in the system. That is known as what? Intensive property. Okay? So I hope the relation between Gibbs free energy and EMF of the cell is clear to you. Okay, moving on to the next concept. Now here, since in chemistry we are discussing about the conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy and electrical energy into chemical energy, here there is reaction in which chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. What happens there? Some oxidation reduction reactions take place. Oxidation as well as reduction reaction take place. Okay, this is due to the presence of what? Due to the presence of ions in the solution. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about electrolyte solutions. That is, the conductivity is due to the presence of ions in the solution. And the substance which can conduct electricity, either in the molten state or in the aqueous solution, that is known as what? Is known as an electrolyte. Okay, now here, the conductance of electrolytic solution is very similar to that of a solid conductor. Okay. So here, before we go for conductance, we shall first discuss about resistance. Okay. So the resistance of a current carrying conductor is directly proportional to its length. The resistance of a current carrying conductor is directly proportional to its length and inversely proportional to its area of cross section. So R is what? The resistance of the current carrying conductor. L is what? The length of the conductor. A is what? Area of cross section of the conductor. Okay. Now when you remove this proportionality sign, you have to add a constant. So R is equal to rho. This is known as rho into L by A. Okay. Where this rho is known as what? It is known as resistivity or specific resistance. Rho is known as what? Resistivity or specific resistance. Okay, so rho is known as what? Resistivity or specific resistance. Okay. Now, first of all, how do you define this resistivity or specific resistance? Okay. So, in order to define resistivity, this has to be one. This has to be one. Then you can define what is resistivity. Means resistivity, it is the resistance of the conductor when the length of the conductor is 1 meter and area of cross section of the conductor is 1 meter square. Okay, see here, very easy. You have to define resistivity or specific resistance. Okay, so this you have to make 1. This will become 1 when length is 1 and area of cross section of the conductor is 1 meter square. So, resistivity or specific resistance, it is the resistance of the conductor when its length is 1 meter and area of cross section is 1 meter square. That is known as what? Resistivity or specific resistance. Now instead of using specific resistance, we are going to use resistivity. Okay. So here, I hope this is clear to you. Okay. Now how do you find the unit of resistivity? You keep rho on one side. Rho is equal to what? You take R into A divided by L. R is equal to, rho is equal to R into A divided by L. What is the unit of resistance? Unit of resistance is ohms. Area is what? Unit? Meter square. Length is meter. So what is the unit of resistivity? The unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Meter square meter. It will get cancelled. So unit of resistivity or specific resistance is what? Ohm meter. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now we come to conductance. The reciprocal of resistance is conductance. Reciprocal of resistance is conductance. So, what was resistance? It was R is equal to what? Rho into L by A. So, this will become what? 1 by rho into, this will become A by L. A by L. Right. Now, this 1 by rho, I can write it as kappa. I can write it as kappa into A divided by L. Into A divided by L. Where this 1 by rho, 1 by specific resistance, I write it as kappa, which is known as specific conductance. Specific conductance. Or conductivity. Or conductivity. Now how do you define this specific conductance? In order to define this should be unity. This should be unity. So, it is the conductance of the conductor when its area of cross section is 1 meter square and the length is 1 meter. Okay? So that is known as what? Specific conductance or conductivity. Now what is the unit of this specific conductance? You keep this on one side, you take the term, other terms on the other side. G into L divided by A. Now G is what? Conductance. Unit of conductance is per ohm or sin. Per ohm or sin. Length is meter. Area is meter square. So this will become sin per meter. Sin per meter. That is the unit of specific conductance or conductivity. Okay? I hope this part is clear to you. Okay. Now here, depending upon the conductivity of the substances, we classify them into conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Okay. Now here, in case of conductors, we have already discussed in the first chapter. In case of conductors, what is the range of conductivity? It is 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 7 per ohm. Per ohm per meter. That is the conductive range of conductors. Then semiconductors. In case of semiconductors, it will be less than conductors. So it is 10 raised to minus 6 to 10 raised to 4 per ohm per meter. That is the conductive range of semiconductors. Then insulators. In case of insulators, the conductivity is still less. So it will be 10 raised to minus 20 to 10 raised to minus 10 per ohm per meter. So depending upon their conductivities, the substances are classified into conductors, semiconductors and insulators. We have other class of substances known as super. superconductors. Now what do you mean by super? Super means very fast, very high. So superconductors means these are substances which have infinite conductance. Means conductance is very very high, which means zero resistance. Infinite conductance or zero resistance. So such substances, what are they known as? Superconductors. We have discussed here metals and their alloys. They are very good conductors of electricity. Semiconductors. Elements of group 14, silicon, germanium, or doped silicon, germanium. They are very good semiconductors. Insulator. We have glass, we have polymers, ceramics. All these are insulators. Okay. Superconductors. There are some metal oxides which will act as superconductors. Even ceramics, they will act as superconductor. Superconductor means what? Which have infinite conductance or zero resistance. Okay. So that is about conductance of electrolyte solutions. Now here just now we discussed about the classification of the substances based on their conductivity. Right. Now if the conductance is due to metals, it is known as metallic or electronic conductor. If the conductance is due to metals, it is known as metallic or electronic conductance. And this metallic or electronic conductance depends upon several factors. What are these factors? The first one is the nature of the metal. Nature and structure of the metal. Now look here. All metals are not very good conductors of electricity. Okay. Copper is there, aluminium is there, zinc is there. All are not equally good conductors of electricity. So here, the metallic conductance depends upon the nature of the metal. Some metals are very good conductors, some metals have a little less conductivity compared to the other metals. So it depends upon the nature of the metal, it depends upon the structure of the metal. Structure of the metal should be such that it will allow easy flow of the electrons. Okay, so that is the first factor. The second one. It depends upon the number of valence electrons per atom. Right. More is the number of valence electrons per atom, more will be the conductivity of that metal. Right. So, more is the number of valence electrons, more will be the conductivity. The third one, temperature. Now look here. How temperature affects the metallic or electronic conductivity. Now, as temperature increases, the metallic conductivity will decrease. Why it will decrease? What happens here when temperature is increased in case of metals? When temperature is increased, there is vibration of the metal atoms. The metal atoms will start vibrating, due to which the flow of electrons is not easy. That is why, as the temperature increases, what happens to the conductivity of the metals? It will decrease. Once again, what happens as temperature increases? When temperature is increasing, you are giving kinetic energy to the atoms. So, the atoms, they will start vibrating. They cannot move because it is in solid state. So, the metal atoms will start vibrating. Due to their vibration, what will happen? There is no easy flow of electrons. Electrons cannot flow easily. The metal atoms are stopping the electrons from flowing easily. That is why what happens to the conductivity of metals as temperature increases? It will go on decreasing. Okay, that is about metallic or electronic conductance. Then we move on to ionic or electrolytic conductance. Now the conductance due to an electrolyte. Is known as what? Ionic or electrolytic conductance. Conductance due to metals is known as what? Metallic or electronic conductance. Right. Now just as the metallic conductance depends upon several factors, same way ionic or electrolytic conductance also depends upon several factors. We will discuss them one by one. Okay. The first one is The nature of the electrolyte. The nature of the electrolyte. There are some electrolytes which are strong electrolytes, like for example NaOH, NaCl, KOH, KCl. These are strong electrolytes. There are some weak electrolytes, like for example HCN, hydrogen cyanide, acetic acid. These are weak electrolytes. So conductivity is more if electrolyte is strong. Conductivity is less if the electrolyte is weak. Okay, that is the nature of the electrolyte. Then the concentration of the electrolyte. More is the concentration of the electrolyte, more is the number of ions. More is the number of ions, more will be the conductivity. Okay. Then, nature of the solvent and its viscosity. Nature of the solvent. We have two types of solvents, polar and non-polar solvents. So, polar solvents will favor the ionization of the electrolyte. Non-polar solvent will not favor the ionization of the electrolyte. So, nature of the solvent and its viscosity. Viscosity means what? Resistance to the flow. Oil is more viscous than water. And the oil surge wagi flow avangilla. Neer et surge wagi flow avangilla. Oil surge wagi flow avangilla. So, now we can think oil is more viscous. Oil viscosity just take me. How that? How does viscosity affect conductivity? Now, the ions are carried by the solvent. Ions are carried by the solvent. So viscosity just equal to ions surge or even move on the other than the conductivity and the yes, viscosity kadmi as to ionic conductance and it just say it. Yet another ions in the surge or the flow of the flow of the electron kade hokta. Yava viscosity just say it is surge or the flow of the electron ions electron kade hokta sarja amanila. Avagi with the conductivity kadmi. Okay. Then next we have temperature. Now, how does temperature affect the ionic or electrolytic conduction? When temperature increases, the movement of the ions towards the electrode will increase. The movement of the ions towards the electrode will increase. That is why the ionic or electrolytic conductance will also increase. The last factor, that is the size of the ions and their solvation. Just ions sannu irtava. Smaller the ions, they will move easily towards the electrodes. And more they are hydrated, their movement will be less. Just ions hydration jasti agirthiti, ashta the movement slow agirthiti. Just agar hydration kadmi irthiti, ashta movement fast agirthiti. So, the conductance also depends upon the size of the ions and their solvation. So, smaller is the size of the ions and lesser is the hydration. Hydration is the level surrounded by water molecules. Yes, the hydration can be activity, after solvation can be activity, after easily electrode can flow out. Yes, the ionic size big activity. Yes, the hydration just see. After conductance in activity, can be activity. Like on the surge by the electrode can be okay, so that is about ionic or electrolyte conductance. We come to the last part of the chapter for today, that is measurement of conductivity of solutions. Now here I told you we are discussing about the conductance of electrolytic solutions. That is the conductivity due to ions present in the solution. Okay. Now here, when you are measuring the resistance, first we go to the resistance, then we come to the conductivity. When you are measuring the resistance of a conductor, now here the conductor is what? Electrolytic solution. So here in measuring the resistance of the electrolytic solution, there are two problems we face. What is the first problem we face? If you pass direct current, when you are measuring the conductance of electrolytic solution, if you pass a direct current, DC is what direct current. If you pass direct current, what will happen? The composition of the electrolyte changes. इलेक्ट्रोलाइट कॉम्पोजिशन चेंज आगे अदर कंटेंट ऐन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट चेंज आगे अब फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम सेकंड प्रॉब्लम फॉर मेजरिंग द रेजिस्टेंस यू आर यूजिंग व्हीटस्टोन्स ब्रिज इन्हें फिजिक्स ना करते फॉर मेजरिंग द अननोन रेजिस्टेंस यू यूज व्हीटस्टोन्स ब्रिज सो व्हेन यू यूज व्हीटस्टोन्स ब्रिज यू कैन डायरेक्टली कनेक्ट इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ मेटालिक वायर व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज ना कंडक्टर हैंग कनेक्ट मारती बाय मेटालिक वायर ओके और बाय यूजिंग अ सेल राइट सो हियर द सेकंड प्रॉब्लम इज दैट आयोनिक सॉल्यूशन कैन नॉट बी डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड लाइक अ मेटालिक वायर cannot be connected like a metallic wire or a solid conductor with a connect madak varangilla adakka how that so you can have problems bartava when we are measuring the resistance of the ionic solution so these two problems are overcome how do we overcome these problems the first problem is overcome by using alternating current the direct current use madodre en martti namo alternating current use martivi how that adu first problem overcome Second problem I overcome martivi in order to find out the resistance of that unknown solution we are using conductivity cells we use conductivity cells so those two problems are overcome by this method first is we are using alternating current instead of using direct current second is you use conductivity cells these conductivity cells can be filled with the unknown solution to find its conductivity okay now conductivity cells what are these conductivity cells the conductivity cells they contain platinum electrodes coated with platinum band conductivity cell contains the platinum electrodes which are coated with platinum black platinum black in mat platinum black and you know finely divided platinum powdered form of platinum in mat the platinum foil mat coating kodutte yedakka for absorb for taking up of the electron okay and same quantity it provides the surface the platinized platinum electrode will provide the surface for gaining or losing of electrons so that is the purpose of coating platinum black on the platinum foil okay so here now these platinum electrodes they are separated by distance of l I'll show you So this is the conductivity cell consisting of two platinum electrodes. These are the platinum electrodes. So coated with platinum black. They are coated with platinum black. The distance of separation is L. The distance of separation between the electrodes is L. Their area of cross section. This area of cross section is A. Area of cross section is A. So the column of the ionic solution. The column of this ionic solution between these two electrodes. Is having length L and area of cross section is A. Whatever ionic solution is there between these two electrodes, it is having length L because these electrodes are separated by distance L. What is the area of cross section of this column between the two electrodes? It is A. Right. So how we are going to determine the conductivity of the unknown ionic solution? So we are going to use conductivity cells. I have shown you a type of conductivity cell. Okay, now look here. We have already discussed the resistance of a current-carrying conductor is given by R is equal to rho into L by A. R is equal to rho into L by A, where rho is what? It is known as the resistivity or the specific resistance. I will take its reciprocal. So, R is equal to rho is equal to what? 1 by kappa into L by A, into L by A. Okay. Now this L by A length divided by area. Okay, this is known as self constant. It is known as self constant because the distance between the electrodes and their area of cross section remains constant. So this L by A is known as what? Self constant. Okay. Now here, in order to find out the conductivity of ionic solution, there are two steps involved. First, you determine the self constant. Next, you determine the resistance of the unknown solution. So first step, find out the other discuss part. To find the self constant. Now, in order to find the cell constant, L by A, which is also known as G star, Okay, so here we are going to use Wheatstone's bridge. Okay, so what is this Wheatstone's bridge? Look here. This is a Wheatstone bridge consisting, I hope you know these symbols. This is variable resistance, you can change this resistance. This is the conductivity cell. These are two resistances, R3 and R4. These are known, this is also known. This you have to find out, R2 is unknown. Okay, P is what? It is a detector, like a headphone or some other electronic device. Okay, so first of all, to find the cell constant, what do you do? In this conductivity cell, you fill a solution of KCl. This conductivity cell is first filled with solution of KCl, whose conductivity you know. Its conductivity is known. Cell constant find out conductivity material first time with conductivity cell naga KCl solution hakthiri. This KCl solution will conductivity gotirthi. Barabara temperature conductivity gotirthi. How that? So, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಕೆಸಿಎಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಿ. ಹಾಕಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಇದು ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಸೆಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್? ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಜಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಇಂಟು ಕ್ಯಾಪ. ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್. ಹೌದಾ? ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕೆಸಿಎಲ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಗೊತ್ತೈತೆ. ಏನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರ ಅದ್ರದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಈ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಸೆಲ್ ನ ಕೆಸಿಎಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಹಾಕಿ. ಹಾಕದ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನೀವು? ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಗೆ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ. ಓ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್. ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಎಸಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಇದ್ರ ಅನ್ನೋ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು? ಯಾವಾಗ ಈ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ, ವೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್, ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್? ವೆನ್ ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್. ವಿಟ್ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಈ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ನಾಗಿನ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವಾಗ ವಿಟ್ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಆ ಕೇಸ್ ನಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ? ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಯು ನೋ R1 ಬೈ R3 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R2 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ R4. Just take the ratio R1 by R3, R2 by R4 for resistance in series. You want to find out this. So R2 is equal to R1 into R4 divided by R3. You know what is this, you can find out R. So you find out what is R, you know what is conductivity. So you get what is the cell constant. Idu gotaithe resistance we find out madthe R2. So nimge en sikthu? Cell constant sikthu. First step moving. Next step in my train to find the conductivity of unknown solution. This is the second step. You are going to use the same setup. Adna Wheatstone's bridge use madu. Adre KCl bagge enirbeku? ಯಾವ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಗೆ ನಾವು ಫಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದೈತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಗೆ ಹಾಕೋಣ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್, ದ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೇಮ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್? R1, these are resistance in series. R1 by R3 is equal to R2 by R4. R2 you find out ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, resistance ಎಷ್ಟು ಐತಿ ಹೌದಾ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಈಗ? ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? KCL ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? ಯಾವ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದೈತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಫಿಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಹೌದಾ. ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ, ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಹಾಕಿರ್ತೀರಿ? R1 by R3, these are resistance in series. These are resistance in series. So R1 by R3 is equal to R2 by R4. R2 unknown resistance by what part? R2 is equal to what? R1 into R4 divided by R3. So if unknown resistance one, unknown resistance one, then that G star what is? G star we know cell constant. The first step we find what part? So kappa is equal to G star divided by R. Cell constant first step like find out matter. Other value substitute matter. Resistance you find out matter. Here unknown solution happy. So ito gote ito gote. You can determine its conductivity. So that is how you determine the conductivity of unknown solution. I hope this is clear to you. We shall stop here for today. Okay, thank you.